gonna say, but this is my mind.
This is my mind.
I am.
I am.
Who says I am?
Who says I am?
I have.
I have.
What it says I am?
What it says I am?
I can do.
I can do.
What it says I am?
What it says I am?
Today.
Today.
I'll be taught the word of God.
I'll be taught the word of God.
My mind is alert.
My mind is alert.
My heart is set.
I will never be the same.
Isaiah chapter 9, and we're going to share with you from those particular passages of scripture this morning. So if you find the book of Isaiah chapter 9, up to God, my wife's going to read a few scriptures for us this morning. Isaiah chapter 9. So when you get there, say amen.
Amen.
Isaiah chapter 9.
Isaiah chapter 9. Amen.
Amen.
Verse 2. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them had the light shined. Thou hast multiplied the nation and not increased the joy. They joy before thee according to the joy in harvest, as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of his burden and the staff of his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, as in the day of Midian. For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise and garments rolled in blood. But this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Amen. Amen. Let's just stop there. I want to share this particular passage of scripture with you on today, man. And I tell you what, I do believe that we have a word. I want to encourage you, and like never before, amen, we put our minds on, you know, the goodness of the Lord and what he's done for us through sending his son Jesus to be our Redeemer. Now, according to statistics, approximately 85 billion people have lived on planet Earth since it was created. At the present time, there are approximately 8 billion people living on planet Earth, amen. And you, let me tell you something, you can travel anywhere on the planet, you can look it up, and you can investigate, come on, all the religions of the world, and at the end of your travels, and at the end of your investigation, you will conclude in all of history past that there has never been anyone, there is not anyone now, and there will never be anyone like Jesus. Hey, the Bible says, he said, hey, his name, what, read that verse 6 again for me.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
I'm telling you, you can travel all over, but you just pick the place. Travel anywhere in the world you want. Come on, you can investigate every religion that is on the planet. You will find that there is not anyone like Jesus. And I want to talk to you from that topic today. There's nobody like Jesus. There's nobody like Jesus. Let me tell you something. Jesus is higher than the highest. Jesus is greater than the greatest. Jesus is mightier than the mightier, man. Come on, Jesus is lovier than the loveliest. He always was. Come on, he always is. And he always will be. Jesus, I'm trying to tell you today, I need you to hear what I'm talking about. There's nobody like Jesus. I love to call that name. I'm trying to tell you, that's my Lord Jesus. There's nobody like Jesus. And Jesus is unmovable. Jesus is unchangeable. Jesus is undefeatable. Look, I've heard people say that someday Jesus will defeat the devil, but I got some good news for you, because Jesus has already. He has not only defeated the devil, he defeated the devil in three worlds. Let me tell you what I'm talking about. Okay, let me tell you something. He has already defeated Satan in heaven. Because why? Because he's already kicked him out.
Kick him out.
In the Gospel of Luke, chapter 10, verse 18, the Bible says that Jesus said, I beheld Satan come on as lightning, falling from heaven. Amen. Yes. Come on. Hey, I believe it was a big fight. I mean, all it was Jesus said, you got to go, and he was out. So he's already defeated him in heaven. Jesus already defeated Satan on earth.
Yes.
He defeated Satan on earth when he rose victoriously from the grave.
Uh-huh.
Hey, if Satan would have known the outcome of the cross, the Bible said that they would not have ever crucified the Lord of glory. Uh-huh. See, because when they crucified him, but Jesus rose from the grave. Uh-huh. Come on, so he's already defeated him in heaven, he's already defeated him in earth, but he's also already defeated him in hell.
Uh-huh.
The Bible says, come on, let us know that before he ascended up on high, he descended into the lower parts of the earth. In other words, he made a trip to hell. He opened the doors, come on, and let the saints of old out that were in captivity.
Yes.
He led captivity.
Yeah, all right.
Glory to God. Come on, I'm trying to tell you, that's nobody like Jesus.
All right.
In the book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 18, Jesus said, I am he that liveth and was dead. And behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen. And I have the keys to hell and death.
Yes, I'll
tell you what I'm talking about. And that lets me know that Satan is not going to be defeated someday in the future. But not only is there nobody like Jesus, there is no other name like the name of Jesus. And in the book of Philippians chapter 2, verses 9 and 10, it tells us that God has highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. And at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow in heaven, and the things in earth, and the things under the earth.
Yes.
The name of Jesus is above cancer.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? The name of Jesus is above heart trouble.
Yes.
His name is above arthritis.
His name is
above high blood pressure. Satan himself is going to have to come on, bow and confess that Jesus is the Christ. Come on, regardless of what men may preach or what they may teach, salvation is not in the church. Salvation is not in religion. Salvation cannot be earned. Salvation does not come through Buddha. It does not come through Muhammad or any other religious leader. Salvation only comes to a lost and dying world through the name of Jesus.
All right.
Come on, hey, look here. The Bible said neither that salvation in any other name, come on, but the name of Jesus. Come on, that's nobody like Jesus.
Nobody.
I'm pretty good up in here.
All right.
Who do you know except Jesus, who was born in a stable, lived for 33 and a half years, was crucified on a cross and buried in a borrowed tomb, and 3 days later rose victoriously from the grave? Glory to God. Come on, why what I'm saying? Jesus didn't need a tomb of his own. All he needed was a bar tomb. Jesus already said, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I'll raise it up again. He was destined to go to the grave, but thanks be to God, he was also destined to walk in the grave. In the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11 and verse 26, the Apostle Paul tells us that as often as we partake of the communion elements, come on, talking about the bread and the crackers here, amen, as often as we partake of it, we do show his death until he comes.
Uh-huh.
Now that's important right there, because in other words, Jesus is coming back.
Yes. Yes.
So he's not showing death until he comes.
Uh-huh.
He's coming back a second time, amen. Come on, but this time, come on, will not be like the first time.
Right.
You hear what I'm saying? Come on, the first time he came to die.
Uh-huh.
The second time he comes, he will come to raise the dead.
All right.
The first time he came in meekness, but the second time he comes, he's going to come in majesty.
Yes.
The first time he came in poverty, but the second time he comes, he's going to come in power.
Yes.
Come on, the first time he came to receive a crown of thorn, but the second time he's going to come with a crown of gold.
Yes.
The first time he came as the lamb, come on, but the second time he comes, he's going to come as the lion of the tribe of Judah.
The first time he came as a baby, but the second time he comes, he's going to come as the king of kings and the Lord of lords. All right, now come on, let's go back. Jesus himself in the book of Revelation chapter 1 and verse 8, he said, I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. In other words, what Jesus was saying was, I am the A and I am the C, and everything in between.
He said, I'm the A, I'm the Almighty God. I'm the B, I'm the Deliberate God. I'm the E, I'm the Eternal God. I'm the A, I'm the Faithful God. I'm the G, I'm the Great God. I'm the K, I'm the Keeping God. I'm the L, I'm a Loving God. I'm the N, I'm a Mighty God. I'm the N, I'm a Near God. I'm talking to you over here. He's an overcoming God, and he's always down to the sea because he's a zealous God. Nobody like Jesus. Come on, the first, look, and he's the first and the last, which means that there's nobody before him, and there's nobody after him.
Amen.
The Bible tells us that one day Jesus was having a discussion with the religious leader, and he told him, look, he said, look here, he said, before Abraham was, I am.
All right.
They didn't understand what Jesus was saying.
Yeah.
They tell Jesus, how can you make such a claim, come on, now or not even 50 years old?
Right.
They didn't realize what they didn't understand was that Jesus back didn't begin when he was born in Bethlehem.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying?
That's
when he was manifested in the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
But the truth of the matter is Jesus pre-existed before he physically existed.
Come on.
According to John chapter 1. Verses 1, come on, Jesus said this here. The Bible said, look at, the Bible said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God. Then in verse 14, it said this here, and the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. It has nobody like Jesus.
Nobody.
He pre-existed before he physically existed.
Yes, yes.
Come on, he was from the beginning, glory to God. Come on, hey, come on, what I'm saying. Hey, he can be found in every book of the Bible. Let me explain. See, most people think he's Jesus in the New Testament, but he can be found in every book of the Bible.
Amen.
Let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. In the book of Genesis, he's the seed of the woman, man.
Yeah.
In Exodus, he's the Passover lamb.
Yeah.
In the book of Leviticus, he's the high priest. In Numbers, he's the pillar of fire by night and a cloud by day. In Deuteronomy, he's the priest like unto Moses, man. Come on, in Jeremiah, he's the captain of salvation.
Judges,
he's the judge and the lawgiver. In the book of Ruth, he's the kinsman redeemer.
Yeah.
In the book of Isaiah, he's the prince of peace.
Come on.
He's the weeping prophet. That's nobody like Jesus.
Come on, look at
all the way down to the book of Malachi, where he's the one, the son of righteousness, but healing in his way. Glory to God. In the Old Testament, we see Jesus concealed, but in the New Testament, we see Jesus revealed.
Uh-huh.
In the Old Testament, he's the picture. Come on, but in the New Testament, we see him in person.
All right.
In the Old Testament, we see him in the shadow, but in the New Testament, we see him in suffering.
Yeah.
That's nobody like Jesus.
Nobody.
Hey, who else do you know but Jesus, who had an earthly mother and a heavenly father?
Come on, I'm going to say, just like
we inherit things, come on, some things from our mother, and then other things from our father, the same is true about Jesus.
All right.
You know, they say, oh, they got their mother's eyes. But he got his father ways. You inherit stuff from your mother and your father. But Jesus did the same thing. Let me tell you what I'm talking about. Come on, I'm going to say, come on, on his mother's side, he was the son of man. But on his father's side, he was the son of God.
All right.
Come on his mother's side, he was the seed of David. But on his father's side, he was the root of David.
Uh-huh.
And on his mother's side, he preached the word, but on his father's side, he was the word.
All right.
Come on his mother's side, he was 33 and a half years old, but on his father's side, he was the ancient of days.
Yeah.
On his mother's side, he died on the cross, but on his father's side, he rose from the grave with all power.
In his hand. Amen. Come on, nobody.
God, let me tell you, he guards us and he guides us.
Yes,
and he heals the sick and cleanses the leper.
Yes.
And he
yes.
gives the sinner and deliver the captive. Yes. And in the book of John, chapter 14 and verse 6, Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the light, and no man cometh to the Father but by me.
Yes.
Come on, and what that really means is that he is the doorway to salvation.
Yes, he is.
And he's the pathway to peace. Man, he's the highway to holiness, man. Jesus is the gateway to glory, and he's the master of the mind. That's nobody like Jesus, man. He was Abraham's sacrifice. And he was Noah's rainbow. Jesus was Abraham's but ram in the bush. And he was Isaac's well. Hey, Jesus was Moses' brother. He was Elisha's man. Hey, he was Samuel's anointed
one.
And he was David's slingshot.
Come on, man.
Nobody like Jesus. I tell you, you can search all over the world.
Uh-huh.
I nobody like Jesus.
Yeah.
God, praise the Lord. Come on, wife. Hey, he's a father to the orphan. Hey, he's a husband to the widow.
Yeah.
He's a spring of water in a dry and weary land.
Yeah.
He's the bright and morning star.
Come on.
He's the brightness of God's glory. He's the rose of Sharon and the lily of the valley.
He's
the express image of God. Come on.
David
said, he's my rod and my staff.
Yeah.
Come on. He prepared the temple for in the garden. Come on. And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, he's unmovable. He's unchangeable.
Yeah.
He's undefeated, man. His goodness is unlimited and his mercies are everlasting. Come on, glory to God. He reigns in righteousness and his yoke is easy and his burden is light. Nobody like Jesus. His
voice
is manifold. Come on, he's the Messiah and the Christ. He's the high priest and the teacher, man. Come on, he's the redeemer and the savior. He's my joy, he's my comfort, my security. He's the Lord that rules my life, man. Come on.
Yes, yes.
You know what I'm talking about.
Come on.
Come on, I know that he would never leave me. Come on, he won't ever forsake me. Hey, he's not going to ever overlook me. He's not going to mislead me. Come on, he will never forget me.
Come on,
if I fall, come on, he'll lift me up.
If
I fail, he'll forgive me.
Yes.
Come on, and when I'm weak, he'll give me strength.
Yes.
The Lord can't understand him, and armies can't defeat him, and schools can't explain him.
No.
And power couldn't find any fault in him. Death couldn't handle him, and the grave couldn't hold him.
Nobody like Jesus.
I'm trying to tell you, look here, if we put our minds on him today, come on, we got to remember, hey, I can search all over the world. I'm going to find that there's nobody like Jesus.
Nobody.
Come on, he can turn your life around, turn your frown into a smile. He can give you hope again because there's nobody like Jesus.
Who
else do you know? Come on, can take a street walker and make him out of a tongue talker. Take somebody from a dope kid and put him behind the pulpit.
Come on, you can take you
from God above, come on and save you to the uttermost and take a nobody and make them a son.
Amen.
You can travel anywhere you desire. Investigate all the religions of the world at the end of your travels, and at the end of your investigation, you will conclude that there may be many gods.
Come on now.
Amen. Come on, man. There may be many gods.
All right.
But there, come on, you'll discover that there's nobody like Jesus.
Nobody.
I'm trying to tell you, man, I know what I'm talking about. Hey, you can take it from the dope pit.
All right, now.
Go ahead. Come on, man. Come on, you remember that. He can be found from the book of Genesis to Revelation.
Yeah.
The first time he came, but he's coming back again a second time.
Yeah.
He'll be the same.
Yes.
Glory to God. I'm trying to tell you, I'm excited about it.
Oh, yes.
Lord, oh, that's the mention of the gospel today. There's no other like Jesus.
Come on. All right.
Oh, my.
Today, I want you to remember that, man. Come on, that's no
body. No body.
And particularly the elements that say, that's no body like Jesus.
No body like Jesus.
Come on, let's pray. Father, we thank you today for this message. Thank you, God. We thank you, God, that we are people, God, that Father, we understand, Father, that you are the God of all power, you are the God of all might.
Yes.
There is none like you. Even if we sin for all eternity, God, we simply find there is none like you. So we just thank you today. We give you glory. We give you our love. We give you praise in Jesus' name.
Amen. All right, Pastor.
Okay, y'all want for the presence, all right?
Nobody like you.
Oh, yes, Lord. Nobody like you.
All right.